Okay, welcome to another episode of the On.net Show. Today we're going to be learning about PolicyServer from Michele and Brock. Can you folks quickly introduce yourselves?
Sure. I'm Michele Bustamante, and
My name is Brock Allen.
Okay. And so today we're going to talk about PolicyServer. Maybe you guys could give just a quick intro of what that is, what the space is that it inhabits, if there's any other offerings that are kind of close to it, and how someone would get this.
Right. So PolicyServer is a product that we're putting together, and the we is Michele, myself, and Dominic Beyer. We have all been working in the security industry for many, many years, and you know, mainly focusing on identity and access control, mm-hmm. things like single sign-on and web API security. We've even built an open source framework called IdentityServer, which mm-hmm. is quite a popular thing, for helping people do their authentication. Okay, and inevitably, once you've figured out your authentication, you need to figure out then after that your authorization.
Right. Okay,
what can people do in your app? So all these years of doing consulting, we've helped people do their authentication story, and then you know we've never had a really good answer for the authorization bit. So for the last couple of years, we've really put our heads together looking at ways people are doing it in the various customers that we help, looking at people how people use our open source project, and you know, try to figure out authorization. And you know, inevitably, everybody's kind of rolling their own.
Right. So
the architecture that you typically get to when you do your identity correctly is you end up with a centralized token server that does your authentication. That's how you do single sign-on, right?
Right.
So that's what Identity Server does, but Azure Active Directory, and there are other commercial products out there like that.
Right, and I sometimes hear people talk about bearer tokens.
Yep, and bearer tokens are absolutely part of that.
The Identity Server
how
product.
You present the identity, right? Like
yeah.
the result of authentication is right. a token that you can present to your applications.
Right. So
right.
The once you've gone to the effort of centralizing this stuff and setting this up, you know, like I said, you have to think about authorization. And so it sounds kind of like good on paper that you have the centralized thing that let's put permissions in that as well. But the problem is that actually turns out in practice to not really work out. The centralized identity system is really good for putting the stuff about the user that's the same across all your apps and APIs. You know, the user ID is the same across everything, their name and their email. Okay, but now you start putting permissions in there, and it turns out permissions are context specific, right? Two different apps or two different APIs have the different concept of a user's task in the app or what permissions they have. So overloading the centralized identity system with permissions, like I said, we've seen this in practice. It actually doesn't work out so well.
And it also sometimes produces even if you wanted to do that, there's too many claims then, too many bits of permissions and information that shouldn't really go in a token because it's too much.
Right.
And because you'd have all of the apps, now you'd have to get into what they used to do with claims transformation. In this app, I'm going to send these back, in the other app, the other. But now you're conflating doing all that work in the identity system when really, why shouldn't that be managed as part of more of an authorization management story, right? Like across all of the apps, who can do what, and so forth. So
It's fundamentally our philosophy is that these are two separate concepts. There should be a separation of concerns.
Understood. There are also cases where, say, within a company, there's some applications that, in their totality, that are only available to say certain members of the organization, like the CEO and senior staff. And you wouldn't want any part of that application available, including the authorization piece, mm-hmm. Available to just anyone. So just being able to cordon that off completely is a benefit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the other thing is those roles that, you know, where you logged in is a piece of identity information. Did you come from the central domain, right, Azure Active Directory or wherever? Or did you get these roles assigned to you? I'm in the marketing department, and I'm in, you know, I don't know, the finance department. Those are all information about your identity. Those are roles, but those are roles related to identity that need to get mapped ultimately into what the app cares about, right? And,
right.
and so that's another part of separation that we can leverage.
Yeah, and the abuse sense. That we've seen in the past
right.
is that people overload roles and treat them as permissions. And so there's a real subtle distinction, right?
Right.
So you're a PM or you're a dev, Well, that's your identity, but can you get to this repo or do this function is more authorization related.
Right. Right. Now, so we talked about policy server and identity server. Does policy server only work with identity server, or can it work with other options?
No, that's a great question. So we've deliberately decoupled them. They're really unrelated.
Okay.
It's just, you know, we work in the space, so it is the logical progression. So no, you can use any identity system you want to log in. You can use ASP.NET identity, just like right there in the app. You can use Azure AD or identity server. Yeah, anything you want.
Okay, makes sense.
Yep.
And before we get too much deeper into this, if people are really interested, where would they go to find out more information?
Yeah, you can go to policyserver.io.
Okay.
What we've done is we have the commercial product that is an implementation of this design philosophy that we believe in. But we did put out a small open source implementation as well. So policyserver.io will give you a link off to the open source version,
okay.
but a link to the commercial.
And is that a GitHub project?
Yeah, so the open source version is really more about illustrating the separation of concerns, giving you a way to, in an application that's simple, have a JSON-based policy that our client tools will load and enforce in the application. And it integrates really nicely with, say, ASP.NET Core's, you know, authorization policy implementation as well. So that will be something you see. And then when we get into the product, it's really more about a management UI where you can actually see the application policies you've created and lay those out and assign users and integrate where the users come from to do so. And then we also have like various levels of that product, right? So like basic entry point so that people that just have a simple problem to solve but need the UI, we have an entry point, which is basic. And then we have single host kind of thing. And then we have the distributed sort of scalable enterprise model that has, you know, different APIs and an ability to distribute those APIs across your server, whether it's Docker-based or container platform-based or not.
And it
gives you multi-tenant support. Yeah. It gives you audit trails so that you can see who assigned what to who and when, and when they've requested policy evaluation, who's the user, what. So having that visibility into your whole ecosystem of all of the applications is really important for compliance for some customers.
Oh, I can imagine.
Yeah.
So you just talked about kind of the web portal UI. So maybe we could take a look at that and see what that looks like.
Sure. So that's actually what I have up here on my screen is our basic version of the management portal. And it's in here that you model these things called policies. The policy is something that you can think of as the manifestation of an application or an API's authorization rules. Okay. So you typically create a policy for each of your apps that care about utilizing the authorization feature. So we created a little demo here for Channel 9. Mm-hmm. And so the idea is we model application-specific roles and application-specific permissions. So this is for the, what I said, you know, roles sometimes get abused and for identity or for authorization. In a policy, this is purely for authorization purposes.
Right, so you did it correctly here.
Yes, yes, that's, I would like to think so. So an application, you know, we could have used other paradigms for manage or representing authorization, but people basically get the idea of roles and permissions.
Yeah, so I've heard this term bandied about, which is RBAC.
Yep.
Which I believe is role-based access
authorization, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Is that what
role-based access control.
Yeah, is that what we're talking about here?
Yeah, I mean, this is very similar ideas and basically the same thing, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but the idea, too, is that with roles, obviously, again, we talked about the distinction between an identity role and an actual, you know, application role, and then application roles can be a way to aggregate more granular permissions, and the reasoning behind that would be that the permissions themselves, think about it this way, roles can change, right? You could have multi-tenancy where admin means something different to customer A or B, and they want to be able to say, oh, I want to take my admin out of this area of the app. Well, how do you do that? The app area needs a permission. So granular permissions can be associated with concrete artifacts in your app that will never change. That association is concrete. And yet the role can be more vague and assign, right? And this isn't a new concept, right? We've done it before over and over, and other applications may have done that internally. But it's just trying to make that a utility that works for any scenario, right? So that
right.
you can customize those roles across tenants and assign the different permissions and visualize how that applies to everybody. So.
Makes sense.
Yeah, and another piece is that, again, this is scoped, think of it, to the application.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned access tokens
yeah.
a little bit earlier. The design of OAuth, when you have an access token, is that the access token can be called used to call Web API 1 or Web API 2 or Web API 3. And if you start packing the access token full of roles, which is kind of our belief as an anti-pattern, then you know you might have admin, mm-hmm. and you use the token at Web API 1, that might be legit. You're an admin at API 1. But if you call Web API 2, maybe you shouldn't be in this admin. So that's why these policies are per application.
Right.
Okay. All right. So yeah, pretty basic idea here. We have roles. We then have, so we set up an interviewer and a producer here for Channel 9. And we map users to these roles. And we have various ways to map the identity, you know, who the user is, to these application-specific roles, right? User ID and based on roles coming from your identity system. And we even load up Kestrel and can do arbitrary evaluation of identity information to indicate that you're in a particular role.
Right. So I was reading your website before this, and it talked about the fact that there's this web UI, which is what we were looking at, mm-hmm. but it also said you can do everything via an API that the site exposes. Mm-hmm. And so you can drive the policies that way. The thing I was wondering about is I can certainly imagine how I would automate telling your server what my applications are. Mm-hmm. And I guess I could imagine telling it what the roles are. It's just, it wasn't quite clear to me how someone would author, I guess, a complete relationship between roles and permissions mm-hmm. in absence of doing it through a system like this.
I see.
Like, what's kind of the scenario, I guess, where people would use the API to like completely replace what they would do through
saying.
This?
Right.
Yeah, or is that that's not the scenario?
I think I know what you're trying to get at is that, you know, if you don't have the UI, how would you know what you're modeling
exactly.
in order to... But it's interesting because we actually do have customers already that we've been talking to who need to automate building the permissions and building the assignments of those permissions dynamically based on resources in their application. And our UI can't solve that problem because it's very opinionated about their system. So either they want to integrate to our API to build custom UI integrations, mm-hmm. or they want to integrate because at the back end, they're going to use our scalable engine that can evaluate policies and do decision-based, do I have access to this resource, do I have access to that resource? But in order to do that, they'd have to be able to, when they create the resource in their app, generate the permission.
I see.
The assignment.
I guess it could also be the case that they have some other database mm-hmm. that describes something for another reason. Maybe it's their own employee database, and it knows the difference between, you know, people in HR versus legal versus their engineering team. Mm-hmm. And then they kind of use that information to drive what's in PolicyServer.
Right, and that's the distinction between identity and permissions.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So we have these role mappings, and did I say Kestrel a second ago?
Yes.
Actually, I meant Roslyn, right?
Okay.
Didn't make sense. So anyway, yeah, we have these roles, the ability to map users onto them, various techniques, and then we define permissions. So these are the things that the app really cares about, right? The actions that a user might be taking. So again, you're simply mapping these application roles to permissions.
Right. So let's talk a little bit about how you built this site. I think not only can you use it with .NET, but I believe you built it with .NET.
Right. So we actually built this with ASP.NET, ASP.NET Core, excuse me.
And that's where Kestrel comes in.
Yeah. Well, Kestrel's on the mind. Absolutely, Kestrel's involved. So we have a runtime API. So a client application needs to connect at runtime. So we have a runtime API where you take the authenticated user, send it to the runtime API, you pass the information about the user, and you tell the runtime API, hey, this is the Channel 9 app. All right, and based on that context, we look up the right policy and do our magic. So we produce those results. So that's runtime API, ASP.NET Core. We have this management system. The front end right now is built in MVC Core, ASP.NET Core MVC.
Yeah.
I had to get that right. And there's a back-end API for management as well, which is, again, ASP.NET Core. We're using Entity Framework on top of a database.
Yeah. Regular mm-hmm. types it's, of things.
Yeah, I mean, the database is pluggable, but we're starting out native, right, with all the things that you would see with most customers in ASP.NET Core-based application with SQL Server in the back, right?
Yeah. When this is hosted, do customers kind of, like, buy, say, your enterprise offering and then they deploy it to the place that they want, or do you have a
hosted? Yeah, we're not doing a hosted offering at this time. It's Docker enabled, so that it can be distributed in a container platform, because we actually do a lot of container platform work together also with our other security projects. And so that's a natural fit, but then also just standard PaaS, you know, or IaaS. So yeah, on-prem, cloud, doesn't really matter to us. It's just a web app.
It's just a web app.
Web app and API with a lot of secret sauce inside, right?
Yeah, totally. Yeah. I'm glad we build a product underneath you that's that flexible. Actually, since you mentioned containers, do you use the images that we provide, or you roll your own?
Well, we obviously the base image, but then obviously we have to.
I meant the base image.
Of course.
Okay.
I would always go for a certified image first.
Yeah, we actually spend
absolutely.
That's important. We spend a lot of effort.
It's important, and also you want to gather the patches that come out with those as well.
Every
month. So exactly.
Yeah, we're pretty serious about that.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have some? Either of you have closing thoughts that you kind of want people to be left with?
No, I mean it's. I'm really excited about this. I think we've given all of our experience seeing customers dealing with this problem. I feel like we've hit a sweet spot here.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty excited
about
that. Yeah,
it's such a common thing, right? Which most of the security projects that we do with all of our team, we run a security practice together at Saliance, right? It's always hitting permissions. It's always hitting authorization. They're always asking for help on that design. And permissions is actually, you know, the way you would approach designing your app and your solution, it's as important that you look at the topology of your app and your microservices or whatever they are, as it is you look at, you know, your identity story, which the security protocols we help people with is because we have experience with that, and that's hard. But we can make it easy, right, if you bring the knowledge. And then add that permissions, it's still another design effort, right? So we're providing a tool that helps you implement the result of the design. And then with the enterprise customers, we're helping them with the design too, because it's just as important, right,
that
you do that properly. So, we're very, very excited. We're getting a lot of good interest already. So
I believe it.
And we've barely launched, you know, so that's
sure.
kind of cool. Yeah.
I know just before the show started, we were joking that, you know, you'd think in 2018 that all this would be solved and behind us, but it's not at all. It's extremely relevant, and there's so many people that want help in this space.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thanks for dropping by.
All right. Yeah. No, thanks.
Great to have you folks and learn about PolicyServer.
Yeah.
And this was another episode of the On.net show. Thanks for watching.